Hey everyone, I'm Sam with Rokoko, and in this video, we're gonna walk through how to set up your new Sony mocopi motion capture system with Rokoko Studio. The first thing we'll do is just take a look at what's in the mocopi box. You can also check out Sony's YouTube channel and website for more information on this system as well. But if we open it up, we got a nice little colorful insert. There's some instructions in here. We have the actual mocopi case. We can just flip this up. We have all the mocopi sensors right here. And then underneath this piece, we've got our straps, right? This is what we're gonna put on our wrists, ankles, hip, and head. And we'll attach our sensors to each strap. And then we'll get everything booted up and we can jump into Rokoko Studio. Now I'll go ahead and put on the mocopi system. So I've already gotten on most of my straps, and you can follow the official mocopi instructions if you need help getting these straps on. After that, I'll pull out the sensors. And before I actually put these on, I'm going to take out my iPhone, which has the mocopi app. I'll start up the app, and I will connect all of my mocopi sensors before I actually put them on my strap. It's all very straightforward, and the app does a great job of providing links to video instructions if you need that. After everything is connected up, I can go ahead and actually place each sensor onto the appropriate strap. I'll have one on my head, two on the wrists, one on the hip, and then two on my ankles. After that, we are now ready to enter in our height and do our calibration pose. So this just involves doing a straight pose with your arms down at the sides. And then once the chime sounds from the app, you take one step forward. And there you go. Now our mocopi system is set up and we're ready to make mocap in mocopi or connect mocopi out to Rokoko Studio. So this process is also fairly easy. You'll want to make sure that you are on the same Wi-Fi network as the computer that you have Rokoko Studio open on. I will open up the settings in the mocopi app and then go to PC connection settings. And I can enter in both an IP address and an outbound port setting. For the IP address, I want to enter in the same IP address that my computer is using for its Wi-Fi network. On my PC, I can find this out by going into the command prompt and typing in ipconfig, but there's a bunch of different ways to figure out what your IP address is. On a Mac, you just go to the networking tab in settings, and you'll want to enter in the IP address of your Wi-Fi network for your computer. Under outbound port settings, the default should be 12351. And if we go up to the settings in Rokoko Studio, you can see that we want to match that with what is there under mocopi listening port. In this case, it matches. So we are good to go. We can hit okay and head back to the main mocopi screen. What we also need to do is make sure that we are in send mode. So you can see up at the top of the UI, there is that save button. And you'll also notice that I'm in the motion tab, not the video tab. And if I hit that save button, it changes into send and the record button at the bottom turns green instead of red. So when we hit this transmit button, we will then see mocopi pop up in Rokoko Studio. And again, you have to be on the same Wi-Fi network and you need to make sure your IP address settings are correct and the mocopi listening port is correct. If we want to record something in Rokoko Studio, we need to add my actor profile. This just contains my height and measurements and makes it so that you can actually now record motion capture in Rokoko Studio. And we can do that by just clicking the red button and we'll record something. But once we're done recording, we will see the actual clip here. And this is one of the great advantages of using Rokoko Studio to record your motion capture. You can actually affect the footlocks for the animation. So a typical process for Rokoko mocap is you'll spend 30 seconds, go through and do some cleanup, and that will guarantee that your motion capture is looking its best. You have no drifting feet or anything like that. And it's really easy to edit these footlocks as well. You can just drag these bars. Green is for the left foot, blue is for the right foot. And you can also see the foot contact reflected in the scene with these circles under our character's feet. So I'll go through, do a quick cleanup. And now we have some motion capture that's looking really good. At this point, we can add a character into Rokoko Studio to do some live retargeting. I'll grab a character that I made of myself that I rigged on Mixamo, import it, and then drag it onto my actor. And now we can see our motion capture on a character in Rokoko Studio. If we wanted to export out this motion capture, we could go right click on the clip, rename it, then we can add it to the export list. And now we have a bunch of options that we can select for exporting this clip, depending on the plan that you're on. And when we're satisfied, we can hit export. And now we have our motion capture data exported and ready to bring into programs like Blender or Maya or Unreal Engine. Another thing you can do in Rokoko Studio is live stream this data out. We have live streaming plugins for Unreal, Unity, Cinema 4D, Blender, Maya, and we have longer tutorials for live streaming on our YouTube channel that you can check out. Finally, you can also connect Rokoko Smart Gloves or the Rokoko Facial Motion Capture Solution to your live mocopi setup to really take things to the next level. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. Please put any questions you may have in the comments down below, or check out our Discord if you need some more help. And we'll also put links to more in-depth documentation in the description. Check back soon for lots of fun new mocopi stuff. This is really interesting technology, and we're excited to be a part of it with Sony. Until the next video, see y'all.